thank God for God raising you from the family,
yeah,
because you stand like a light in the family, and to enlighten your brothers and sisters and educate them to let them know the salvation.
When you told me about my family, I said, God, why did you want to bring me out of that family? I said, you didn't see any family that I will come from. Yeah? I said, what, God? Why did
but
you bring
me? But you are a princess from
why
there.
Bring, yeah,
God, like, who made you to be there?
So
I already didn't know that you were a princess.
For my father's family, no problem. God would have looked for another person. I will come out through that person. For my mother's family, I said, God, why did you go and bring me out for my mother's family? I said, Wesha, everything has happened for a reason. If not me, my siblings would have known anything about the secret going on in my family.
Because it's hidden.
It was a very hidden secret that you cannot even know the prime suspect. I could remember, before I met Pastor Miracle, there is a woman I also met too. This woman is just like a godmother to me. I went to her house. She invited me to her house. When I went to her house, I said, God loved me so much. He said, there is something God wants to do in my life. I said, what? He said, there is a hidden secret in my family that God said is going to reveal that secret to me. I was telling the woman, I said, please, can you tell me the secret? The woman said, she can never, never tell me the secret. He said, there is a time that God has set
totally the secret. The woman, she's afraid of the attack and the problem, you know, because the kingdom of darkness, there is a in case you will step in, they will come and warn you to take, just leave the case. You know, because some of them, if you are not equal to task and step in a case, either they take your life or they useless you.
We have called a pastor in what church was that? Oh, this church, Mountain of Fire. There's a pastor I called on for in Mountain of Fire. People said I should call this pastor. He will go and pray for my. He will go to my place and pray. When I called this pastor, he accepted to go to my place and pray. I gave the pastor the address of the house. The pastor said, God forbid, he can never go to that house. Pastors have come to my mother compound. They will run.
That is what I told you.
They have come to pray. They will. They see different things, they will run, they will not come back. Some of them, there was a time before my second brother died, there was a time they were taking him somewhere. Somebody came to carry this my brother somewhere for deliverance to go on. They said there is a place then in Benin they will take him to, it will be okay. When the person came, they took him, when they were taking him, about 4 minutes later, they returned my brother back. We were asking why. They said, no, somebody just came to warn them I should return my brother back.
You see what I'm talking? That is what I told you. Pastors is by name. There are some people that ordain to do the work. So if there, some of them, before you come, they will warn you. They will attack you. They will attack your wife, your children. They will try to threaten your life. So if you are not called and anointed by the Most High God, you cannot reveal the secret of the enemies. Because the enemies will be after you. Occultic kingdom will be after you. But when they see that you are ordained and you are anointed by the Most High God, the word of God says, sorry that we gather, but I gather this not for you. That is what you say. You will call many pastors, go there, go. At the end, what happened to them? They will run away because they cannot stand before the power of darkness. Only the man of God, the children of God that ordained to serve God, people that call by the Most High God, people that call by Jesus, they are the one that will mention the name of Jesus and the darkness will disappear. You know? So, but glory be to the Most High God that God give us victory. It's not easy because when you are talking this thing now, people will think that it's just an easy thing. All those magic pastors used to do. Come today, tomorrow, they will lay your hand, God have destroyed. It's not easy. You must humble, you must pass and pray, you must follow the ways of Jesus of Nazareth.
I know I went to Belgium and there's a pastor, they told me if I go there, my problem will solve. For me, growing up, I don't believe on pastors.
Yeah.
As I was growing up, anything about pastors, I don't believe on pastors. I know pastors, I had they belong to the occultic kingdom, I have seen them. I've witnessed it, so I don't believe in any pastor. So my husband convinced me, said he saw this pastor, he can pray for me, my problem was solved. That day I was having headache. I don't know, some people call it migraine, some people call it, I don't know, they call it different names. Even when I went to hospital, they call it different names. My husband said I should go and try this pastor, that the pastor is coming to Belgium. I said, okay, no problem. I went there. When I got there, I saw the pastor, I was looking at the pastor, I said, let me have faith. He said, I should have faith. I was saying, let me have faith, let me be strong, let me have faith. They said, I doubt too much. I said, let me not doubt this time around. I went to the Belgium. When I went there, the pastor laid his hand on my head. It's just like the pastor handed a basket of load upon my head. Immediately, the pastor's hand just touched my head. My head, just everything in my life just changed. And now I was carrying a basket of load on my head. When I came back, my husband was asking me about the pastor. I said, just forget that pastor. I said, that pastor is a homosexual pastor. He was looking at me. I said, don't forget about that pastor. That pastor don't have anything. He said, that was before I met you, before I come and meet such pastor. Because I meet different pastors. They used to come from Nigeria. Pastor, why I don't like pastor? When you start talking about if you want to go and pray for people, you enter flight. You use this one, you use this one. So pastor, they will just talk. How they have make money. Where they are living, what they have achieved. All those kind of things. I start looking at that. I saw this one. I've seen many pastors.
And you have sown many seed of faith.
I have sowed seed.
Seed of faith.
I have sowed seed and sowed. My husband.
And the one.
My husband have paid. They will even be telling you, are you not bargain price with God? They will say, if you take us to go and borrow, we should go and borrow. That was what pastors
were telling
us. So of them will tell
you. So that God will heal you.
I've never seen any of them tell me about my problem. They don't tell me, but there was a woman that told me about two people in my family. He said they are the makers of my problem, but he did not tell me the third person. There are three people in my family, very dangerous three people in my family. But now two of them is dead. There's remaining one. I pray God.
God will complete what
God
He finished.
God will complete what He has started. Since I met Pastor Miracle, it has been a blessing moment for me.
He will complete what He started.
God has really changed my life. I know that before I'm a hot-tempered person. But now, I'm not hot-tempered again. I've changed.
The word of God has rebuilt you.
My character has changed. Everything about me. If I call my sisters, I will be telling them, you cannot talk to this person. This person is the one. They will say, I have spirit of boldness in me that God has put in me. Since I met Pastor Miracle, I can say before I met him, what I was really passing through. I was passing through hell. Everyday sickness. I must have one sickness. So today I will have. Tomorrow, even when there's a time I used to go to hospital, there's one
every
hospital.
Day.
They know me there. If I just come, the other doctor will be saying, she have come again. We know her. I will say, I will yell here. I will say, what is that? He will say, abscess. I will even be insulting some doctor. I say, how did you know that I come with abscess this time? It's another sickness that brought me there. I was coming every day. I'm sick.
And you drink tablets every day.
And I take drug. Drug is like just rice and stew for me. Food.
Oh my God.
I was on the sources. I learned many things from Pastor Miracle. If you stop telling people your problem, it's better for you because you don't know who is troubling you. Somebody that is troubling you, it will just be close to you.
Yeah.
My own case was that somebody that I was telling my problem, he was also the one helping me looking for solutions. Yeah. He was the one behind everything,
your problem.
My problem. I remember when I was pregnant of my son. There is a rope that used to come out of my throat. Mm. I didn't tell my husband. There was a rope. I will be cutting the rope. I will be cutting when I see somebody coming.
From your mouth.
From my mouth.
Physical.
Yeah, physical.
Physical.
What I really passed through.
Physical.
From
this thing happened physical.
Physical. There was a rope when I was pregnant.
Okay, I remember that you told me.
There was a rope that I was happy. There was a day I was brushing. That is how it is. I don't see one rope. Rope. White rope, I will cut the rope, I will draw. When I hear the noise of people coming, I will cut the rope. Nobody was knowing what is going on. I said, this thing was occurring every time. I used to cut the rope. Then I was telling myself, is it this rope that used to tie this baby in my womb? I don't understand. So there was something in my pocket they did for me from Africa. They said I should be putting it in my pocket. If I'm sleeping, it should be in my pocket. Anywhere I'm going, I should not remove the thing from my pocket.
Oh my God.
For that day, I just opened the window. I just saw one fresh sun from up. I just look up. I said, God, why is my life like this? Am I cursed? Why is my life like this? And the thought just came to my mind. He said, remove that thing from your pocket and throw it away. I just take that thing out of my pocket. I said, but this, I should not throw this thing away. I just throw the thing inside the bush.
Oh my God.
The day I throw that thing in the bush, that was the day I stopped cutting rope for my throat.
Oh my God.
See, do you see what they did to me?
It's unbelievable.
They are the ones that brought it for me for Africa.
That is the same thing they did to one young guy. Maybe by the grace of God, I will visit him to give the testimony. They give him to wear